All right, so as we explained last week, we're about to watch The Last Dragon all together. So we're going to get set up. So let's go ahead and do that. Assume the position. Maybe, you know, put the laptop next to the TV. And what we're going to do is when I clap my hands, you're going to pause us. And then you're going to unpause it the second you see Taimak's glistening body on the movie The Last Dragon when you're playing, because that's how the movie starts.
Which is around, what, 21 seconds in?
Yeah, 21 roughly. Seconds in after the TriStar unicorn. Okay, so
you ready for the clap?
Yeah, I'm ready.
You at home ready for the clap? All right, one, two, three. Hopefully not the STD clap. So, you ready for the clap? All right. So, opening with the glistening muscles. Although I do have to say, Taimak is pretty badass as a martial artist in this movie.
Yeah, I mean, has he done anything after this?
I haven't seen him, like, before or since, so I don't really know. But, all I know is that he's got the moves in this movie.
This is the role he was born to play.
Oh, I didn't remember that it had, like, he's, you know, he's kicking the credits and that kind of stuff.
It's a lot of, you know, pent-up aggression.
It looks like the floor of my grandmother's basement going up.
How about the glass floor so you can see that?
Look at that. I want to see him go into a full, like, you know, windmill breakdancing style.
So, you being of, you know, one who studies martial arts, how's his form?
His form is tight, I will say. I got no complaints. Right. It's actually one of the best martial arts performances I've ever seen in a movie. Look at him, man.
Yeah.
He's a work of art.
Now he's going to chow down.
Yeah. This music is tight, too.
Now, are they just replaying scenes? Like, all right, he's...
No, that was totally a different chopstick maneuver.
No, of course.
I think Berry Gordy was, like, the guy who started Motown, actually. I was at a party once, and I mentioned this movie, and some guy, Jeremy, came flying from across the room. He's like, are you talking about Berry Gordy's Last Dragon? Freaking out.
Like, he was at that party just for that sole purpose. Why is he shooting arrows at him?
He's testing his, you know, spiritual awareness of projectiles.
So he's going to be busy beating up this with stick, and then he's like, bam! He didn't hit me with that arrow.
It's like Sonya wins. Right, didn't Sonya have a move like that in martial art, in Mortal Kombat?
Yeah, but in the air.
Yeah. Arrow gives some great ecstasy. It's like, no, man.
Well, just catching arrows being shot at me. That patch kept him standing.
It was like Tony Stark. It was like the...
Yeah, that was it.
Touched it.
We now upgrade to guns.
You get to have my falconeering glove.
Yeah.
And it's archery, but
I know.
Some deep shit, man.
You fucked up. Sounds like he's giving him, like, the first lesson now.
Yeah. he's like the low-budget Miyagi.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Yep. Oh, man, you just made him cry.
It's like, I shouldn't have caught that blue arrow.
So dumb, God. He's kind of got like Zoolander hair, a little bit. Zoolander. The master?
Oh.
Like, there's something about the texture. See, just a bit.
Ooh, chocolate coin.
Was it gilt? Or gelt? What do you call that?
Gelt? I don't know.
Seriously, I mean right now.
Get out.
Yeah. I feel like there should be more montage going on with this right now. You know, like pictures of him in like anguish or searching. You know.
Right. Nah, just putting on his Sunday's best.
He's like, fuck this, throws it right in the water. It's like some dumb goy, I get it.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I love this music. I actually had an outfit like that once upon a time. I think it's called like a turtle shirt or something like that with those like buttons, like mm-hmm. the, not the buttons, the rope buttons.
Yeah,
you know what I'm talking about.
It's like a montage in a montage.
Yeah. Which one was this? I'm woefully actually inept at identifying. Is this Fisperia? I can't remember. Do you remember? Are you good with identifying Bruce Lee movies?
No. Sadly,
I don't like that guy. He has like the claw hand. I just can't remember the name of the movie.
With the mirrors.
Well, that's Enter the Dragon then with the mirrors.
Okay. We're just proving our, you know.
I wish I could go to a theater like this. Like I hear like in Harlem, this, you know, this, well, that's a movie takes place, right? But the only experience I've had like this is me and my friend Steve saw the movie Boomerang in a, you know, black neighborhood.
Mm-hmm.
And everyone was going nuts in the theater, and I was like, oh, man. Like, I gotta do this more often. Oh.
He just did that thing that happened in the movie, except in real life, in the movie.
Whoa. Yes.
The ushers are real hardcore in this theater.
Like the Cyndi Lauper girl back there. It's my dream to enter a movie theater like this.
Like this.
Those glasses.
They don't have any practical use except making it hard to see.
Yeah. Sho'nuff.
He's like trying not to laugh.
For you guys at home, this is the moment that will change your life forever if you've never been exposed. The Shogun of Harlem. It's like, you shut up, kid. This guy's awesome. I thought the lackeys' names were Stitch and Cyclone. Maybe they got that messed up.
Nah.
Or maybe it's later when they trash in. Well, I don't want to give away anything.
Is this how he enters every establishment?
He's going to beat up at least three kids during every movie watch. Oh, snap. He just hands him off. And then he kept handing him back. Where are these guys? Where are Sho'nuff's lackeys now?
Is he eating popcorn with chopsticks?
Me and my friend Derek used to do that growing up because we wanted to be cool guys. With his teeth.
What you talking about?
Yeah.
You tell them. Henchmen are great.
Where do I get some of those bracers that Sho'nuff's got? Oh, what? Oh. What? I don't know. Is that supposed to be serious? Like, was that tough guy style?
No, I think that's, I don't have any shirts, so I'm just going to take my sister's.
Oh. Wow, that guy I've seen before. Whoa.
What is that?
Oh, what?
That doesn't even make sense. Why would you do that?
Bruce Leroy, I think it should be noted, had no desire to help that guy out. He just shook his head at that guy.
Yeah. What, does everyone think they know Kung Fu here?
Look, I want to be in this theater so bad. Oh, what?
Cheap shot.
Sho'nuff's not going to abide that.
Get kicked by a guy in a tracksuit.
Oh, kip up. If I remember properly, he bites his ankle here. Yeah.
Because breaking it wasn't enough.
Do you see the Busta Rhymes video for that song? I was like, put your hands where my eyes can see. You know that song?
No.
Nope. Well, anyway, Busta Rhymes is dressed up as Sho'nuff in the middle of the video, and he's like going on the Who's the Master rant. It is awesome. And he looks very close to him. That's good.
Yeah, just a fridge of...
Sometimes you just need a little meat, you know?
A little bit.
Wasn't this guy in Dumb and Dumber?
Yeah, he was...
He was the guy chewing the aspirins, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
I'm sure he's been in other things, too.
That is what Dr. Evil wanted. Whatever's in that tank. Yes?
That lady's just kind of like, what do I do here?
That's Prince's protege, Vanity.
Don't talk.
You'll grow to love her, though. if you don't remember. She actually has some serious character movement. This guy's got some trouble managing the subordinates.
Yeah.
I mean, Vanity's pretty freaky, right? I think that's fair to say, but there is something hot in her freakiness. She got like the vampire like eyes or something, like the makeup
crazy
going on.
Yeah.
I think this is like where the song like came, like this was like the,
he made
know,
the
unveiling of the song.
Mm.
Great montage of 80s weirdness.
Yep.
Which I personally love. Yeah.
Always having a good time.
Yeah. Ugh. Where's Eddie Arcadian now, man? I actually love him in this movie. Pro tip, I think eddiearcadian.com is open, if anybody wants it. Yeah, the chick was taking that serious.
Just doing this dance in the middle of traffic.
I think I saw some suspenders in somebody. That's like the laser background that I had in like my middle school, like, you know, class picture, you know, like the lasers.
Oh, right.
Either, what were your options? Do you remember?
I think you had the blue, the little...
like clouds?
Yeah. Or lasers.
Or cloud lasers?
Nah, that's just...
that's crazy.
Technology didn't exist back then to do that.
No compositing?
No. You had the lasers or clouds?
Is that, what's his name?
William H. Macy?
Yeah. Wow, man. It's funny because he doesn't look that much younger. I just saw Fargo, actually, for the first time a couple of days ago.
Yeah. Never saw that.
All I know is I want that jacket.
Yeah, that...
to put it on my wall, even if not to wear it.
Oh, you would wear it.
This might be the high point of William H. Macy's career. It's probably the worst thing I've ever said.
Was he the manager or just like a guy?
He's our handler. He's not doing a good job handling.
No.
I'm a real and dynamic woman who has many needs that you can't...
sunglasses are off.
Oh, you like Caruso?
Yeah.
What does that say? It's like, for us. Video hot pics.
Yeah.
What? Now, did this sort of thing, like, exist? Like, were there, like, live filmed TV music craziness shows? Is that a thing?
I mean, you spent more time in the 80s than I.
Mm. Yeah, man.
Some crazy eye.
Yeah.
Jive going on.
Yeah, I know. All I know is I dig it, man. I don't know. I'm digging it. It's so weird that I, like, you just have to
think the director's is like,
yeah,
just move around and let it happen.
Look at this. Now it's whisper time. Shit, you can't get up anymore.
Well, this isn't.
Whoa.
It's like full Elvira mode right there. I would hang out here.
That cloud crowd?
Yeah, because they're in seventh heaven.
Oh.
Well, you thought they were like in the Amazon cloud?
Yeah. That's exactly what I was thinking.
Look at those eyes.
Everyone's rocking crazy eyes.
Well, that was actually kind of weak applause.
I don't think she went to the choreography practice.
I think she tried to mix in a little salsa there for a second, but then quickly realized that it was not appropriate.
It's like some lady in like a yellow jumpsuit in the background.
That's normal. Oh, there you go. It's like April O'Neil, man. Totally.
Oh, yeah.
All right? Yeah. I like that. Purple sash, I guess, yeah. That's good. He's like nine.
He's got that hat, so.
It makes that age, he's like 15 essentially with that hat. What's it on?
That's it. It's the hat.
She is into it. Was that an intentional wink or an eye flutter? Couldn't tell.
The start of a seizure.
Yeah.
Any options viable? No.
Oh, damn. Oh, Miss Charles don't stand for that. Look at the guy, he's like adjusting his cuffs.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Yeah. Leroy Green does not suffer lady hitting.
I guess if these guys are smart, they would have, you know,
ooh,
gotten further away from a crowd.
Oh, man.
I thought, like, at that angle, like, a bus would just come in, like, boom.
Ooh. I think he really hit him. Like, that wasn't a stunt. That guy just hit the ground like a sack.
End of his career and his life.
Okay.
He did what he loved. What was that even about? Like, usually if you're holding him like that.
Oh! Yeah. Hey, he totally gave up his, like, hostage advantage.
Right, he's like, I have leverage right now. And
you toss that leverage to the curb.
What? You left your door open. He was doing him a service. I am now.
I like her voice just jumped up like 9 octaves in the presence of such masculinity.
It's like crazy eyes are just out of control now. It's like your eyebrows. Like, what's going on? I can't look at this.
Miss, you seem to be having a neurological condition.
I was hoping like a can of Aquanet would be in that bag.
Soul glow.
And soul glow. Soul glow.
Soul glow.
I'd kill for those taxi rates now.
Yeah, they'll all be robots soon.
Yeah. Those imaginary black martial artists.
It's like the slipper.
That's just... It's like, what do you just like keep that out in the open? This coin.
Where does she do her shopping? Oh, what? That's not how you talk to a lady.
Oh.
And your baby, come on.
And...
Fix your face. That's harsh.
Oh, I mean, she is wearing a triangle. Was it an equilateral triangle, though?
I don't think we had a good enough angle.
That could be what he's, you know, criticizing.
Lack of symmetry pisses me off.
Right, he hates isosceles.
We'll never find some dumb guy now.
No.
Oh. I love how, like, this movie just has a weird sort of, like, subtle, like, racism, but, like, not mean-spirited, but, like, it's hard to, like, define, but my point is that this kind of stuff would never fly in a movie now.
No.
Yes, love that guy. Oh, he's wearing the Bruce Lee outfit from that movie that he never finished or whatever. Which then was in Kill Bill too, right?
Yes.
Well, you just explain it to the guy. He's not going to fall for it. Boom.
Yeah.
wish to fight you, or who you wish to fight then, my man, or one of the ladies, maybe. Yeah, since you're too much of a sissy to fight me, maybe they have more of your speed. Get a girl, so maybe you can get a rise out of this little whip.
Burn. Yeah.
Does a pretty good job reining himself in, I have to say. You go, like, that would never fly in a movie now.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Yes.
Tactics.
You had a little bit of a rhyme going on in there. Feel bad for Leroy here.
Oh, poor Leroy.
Let him go, though.
Yeah, he's shown up as a man of his word.
Kiss the gowns. There was a... I'm not sure, do you remember that there was a shoe store in our town here that was called Sho'nuff? You remember that? It was on, like, Sunrise Highway, I think. And I always wondered, is that just, like, a pun on, like, enough? Or is it...
That.
Sho'nuff, because he was all about the Converse shoes, kiss the cons. I always wanted to walk in there and ask that.
But it closed?
I just, you know, never got around to it.
Well, you have to hit the archives for that one, I guess. That's a slick way of answering
yeah,
the phone.
This guy's got style, man. He knows. Yeah. He knows what it is.
Is that the guy from Coming to America?
No, I don't think so.
No?
You're talking about his the woman's father, right?
Yeah.
McDowell's?
Yeah.
I'll tell him when I can look at him. No.
No. No. Completely normal thing to do.
Yeah. This is what my family had to deal with growing up. I'd do this kind of stuff.
Yeah, it's about how a kid would react to chopsticks.
I like Leroy's family. Pizza. I got that on a t-shirt. It's like, that's it. Like, all channels on the TV for the purposes of this movie are all set to Seventh Heaven.
Yes.
I love the parents. They're like, yeah. That's it. That's what's on my shirt. I love this guy. What is he, 10?
Yeah, he knows everything.
Like, he's like the older brother.
Yeah. I don't get these negotiation tactics.
No, I think it's a solid deal.
Solid deal?
Yeah. I have, like, literally, like, that boombox, like, downstairs somewhere. Back when me and my brother were in breakdancing crew.
Does it still work?
Yeah. I think on the street they would call them Ghetto Blasters. Which is also the name of a Commodore 64 game where you nail people with music.
Nice.
Love the outfit. Oh, so it's in Technicolor.
Yeah. Say Neverland.
Yeah, the pink text.
Yeah.
See, my outfit was just like cotton. He's got some like upgraded like silk shit or something. Cause he reached the arrow catching level.
Blue arrow catching.
Yeah. How did she know that she was being kidnapped at that point? Maybe right. There was thugs inside who were grabbing her?
Which wasn't, again, smart. That truck's got some good pickup.
Good thing it was the most identifiable truck in the world.
Right. Might as well just say bad guy plans on the cover of that.
This is one of the things I love about this movie, that there's like inbuilt movie like videos of music videos. For the Cyndi Lauper girl. What was her name? Daisy?
I didn't hear it.
Oh, Angie.
Angie.
This is awesome. Yeah. I wonder if like they like released an album for like Angie. Like if this movie came out now, that would have happened, you know.
Right.
Yeah. Kind of like Get Into the Greek with all those music videos for like Jackie Q and Super Tight. I tried to do this the nice way. See what I just did there with the words?
Yeah. With the words and things.
Whoa. Some precision door throwing.
Yeah.
At what point does Lord Charles start digging this? That's what I want to know. Nice. See, he's tight, man.
Yeah.
Oh, he's got the joint wheel. Got the freaking arm lock with that thing, too. That's like the point in the video game when you, like, shoot a civilian and you take, like, negative 10 life. Like, damn it.
Right. It's 100 points.
That guy's kidney shattered, though.
I like how no one's moving, like. It's just.
Got your winning Oscar.
Multiple. So they start this conversation and the whole walk back to the apartment just silent.
Yeah.
I never got that.
Yeah. Unless she, ironically, lives directly next to Eddie Arcadian.
Right. In fact, like, her window overlooks his...
Yeah, you silly boy, I got it. It's not all I got for you.
What do you mean?
Oh, man, he is in seventh heaven.
Not Cloud Nine.
Well, he'll be there. How does he keep the gi so tight, man? You know, usually it opens up a little bit, but he's got like
the chi holds it together. Yeah.
He's like, what is my most attractive stance that I can be in? He's like in the horse dance when she comes out. Now you're a champion.
Put this on 50 cent ribbon.
Yeah, is this music actually going on, or is it just like the music in the movie?
The movie?
Yeah.
Hopefully it's the former.
We got some sex saxophone going on now.
Saxophone?
Yeah. He's completely undone.
Blue balls just throw off everything.
That's cute though. Ooh, that was an awesome hat that guy had.
Trust that guy with a beer in his hand on the streets.
These guys. Love these guys.
See, what they don't know is the music playing now is for the movie, and there's actually nothing going on.
They all just have mental disorders, the same mental disorder. There it is. See, that would be like immediately, I can't even believe it, like it exists.
Yeah.
Now I'm confused. Does that constitute racism?
When they do their own thing?
Yeah. I would say somehow yes. But it confuses me. I like the football shoulder pads.
That's... Not yet, guys.
Dial it down.
That guy.
Iron Maiden and Motley Crue. Nice. Oh my god, damn. I knew there was a cyclone.
Not the lattice.
Oh no.
I don't think that was, must have been day old.
Oh, I got screwed up.
Yeah.
Had a double axe handle. We couldn't get the job done.
Still can't get it done. Oh. Is that like... What's going on in the back now?
It's her.
Yeah.
I actually use that quote sometimes. I'm like, ow, oh, not.
Yes, that's the rules of martial arts. You wreck up a pizza place and then...
Now, to be fair, Sho'nuff's toning it down. You know, if you wanted to be really traditional, you would have killed his family. So,
yeah.
I will say, you know, Sho'nuff, he's got a heart of gold in there. It's just like, I never realized it before, like, but I wonder, like, is there anywhere you can, like, get or, like, model, like, get the Sho'nuff wagon?
Oh,
it had
man.
That distinctive style there, I just noticed. That'd be an awesome Halloween outfit, man. Like a group, like Sho'nuff and his minions
that's
coming
me.
Out of that truck. Man. I actually gotta, you know, hit the little girl's room, so you hold down the fort while...
While this movie keeps going?
Yes.
Oh, great.
You got it.
Oh, right. Not trained to defend against pizza parlor attacks. Punch bag did nothing to you.
I missed a sadness montage.
Yeah, he's beating up a defenseless punching bag. He's 2 days away from retirement.
It's okay, the sweat will give him clarity.
He can't hear normal talk, but whispers.
It's because she's not going up the octave? I feel bad for Lord Charles here.
This is not awkward at all.
I like Laura Charles though, because it's like she's super forward, obviously, but also kind of like sort of innocent in a weird kind of way.
Right.
Like, but not? I don't know.
gives me a chance to. That's all right, come on.
I mean, I understand Leroy's hurting right now, but
that's
he can't be, he should be mean about it.
That's just, I guess, what this scene calls for is he's got to project his anger. He's not yet achieved perfection,
I guess.
So yeah. This is like showing the flaws.
Right. That's why he doesn't have the glow yet. Yeah. This guy's amazing. He is a shrewd businessman after all.
Yeah.
I love this. I believe this song is called Test Drive. Yep.
Yep.
That seemed like an impossible sound that they made.
Like how it just looks like she rolls her head in like a makeup drawer and just, well, first glue, then the makeup drawer. Is that like a brake light earring?
Yeah.
Like the side?
Whoa. Like, I don't know, like, I feel like they did a lot more with her character than was kind of necessary for the movie. Like, it's kind of a good arc she goes through, I think. She calls him out.
She's just not a pretty face.
Sick articulation. Boom. She just owned him.
Dropping the truth.
Yeah. T-bomb. Just got like a burlap sack down there instead of like a mat.
Yeah.
It's a lot of backswing. You like the gong?
Yes.
The gong lord?
The gong lord? Is that what he's...
How do the foam folder, like shoulder pads, enhance his battle prowess?
I was wondering the same thing. It's like, it can only be a detriment.
Right.
To our movement.
Like, get it all cleaned up. Oh, that is high art.
You keep saying that word. I think it means what you think. Designate.
It's another point for showing off, though. It doesn't take the money.
It's a man of principle.
Yeah. The irony is that him and Leroy are really close. They're not so far apart. You see, I'm about to go some martial arts mumbo jumbo on you right now.
No way you move that fast in the city. True. In a car.
I do like, you know, it's a little ham-handed, but I do like the martial arts message where Leroy's coming from.
Right.
Yeah.
Believing in the philosophy and
yeah,
all that.
Oh, he went for the friend.
The friend.
He's just falling apart.
Yeah, he's just stick with the kicks and the punches.
I kind of love him though.
I don't think you can apply martial arts to that.
I love it. It's like he doesn't even know how to accept the total green light. He's just like, I'll show you some moves. Like, no, man, it's my friends.
Yeah.
Wait a minute, wait, that's what I want. No, wait. it's about to be.
People just like dance as they walk.
Yeah. I love how that like 10-year-old like goof kid knew the phrase delusions of grandeur.
Yeah.
That other guy was about to say something, but then he got cut off.
Camera's like, we're good here.
Leroy was not impressed at that point. Alright, alright. Sunrise, I like this. It's actually Lord Charles's voice. I gotta put this on my training mix.
It's just a montage telling you exactly what you need to do.
It's a little guesswork here.
Kills her.
Bruce Lee was awesome. So Jeet Kune Do means the way of the intercepting fist, like launch with an attack that happens after the opponent's but arrives first. And you can actually see that in like all of his movie fight scenes. It's cool. It's like 2 feet, man. Come on. And then he just leaned by.
Yeah.
One time I wailed myself in the ear with the nunchucks. You know, going like around.
Yeah. Better that than Temple.
Yeah. I think I hit the boys nice too.
I think it's almost like a requirement.
Yeah.
Anyone who trains with nunchucks.
The one that I totally suck with is the three-segmented staff. That thing just confuses me. It's like the, like a bigger triple matchup. And she's like, that's enough of Bruce Lee. Okay, you're looking over here now.
I'm watching Bruce Lee. Leave me alone.
What if my face was Bruce Lee's face? Does that make it better?
Yes.
She knew what she was doing when she made the montage. She should have timed it better, though.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, that's what I do.
About to rock little bro's world right now.
That's too much.
And then he punches her in the throat. Because that's like the next scene in the movie.
This is where he makes a bad decision due to a moment of
jealousy and anger?
Yes.
You know what? I'm going to burn Sim's head into the ground. I got to go to the
let us do this again. Larry's giving her blue balls.
Bruce just effed her up. She even had the whole like flower metaphor at the end.
Right.
Whoa, where's that other hand?
No.
And the Arcadian's a dick. Oh my god. Are those grandma glasses?
Think so. They have to have like
the wrap around. It will look like it. I'm not sure if they. See, tight security.
Pizza discussion going on.
That was a big polarity change. Rip his face off, though. It's okay.
Thank God,
my plan is working.
But there's blood on the walls.
Yeah. Maybe it is. That bad.
Yeah.
Did not get that at all.
Yeah. He's not gonna give up.
I do most of my martial arts in jeans.
Yeah, like a Nam trip or something. Dramatic turn.
Guy gets points for committing, though.
Yeah.
He's not so uptight that he can't enjoy his work. So like they're wearing like togas.
Abrupt scene transition.
Yeah. You playing like hopscotch? Yeah, I think so, if I remember. Dig the up collar, though. I love Bruce. I love Leroy's plan B here. Is he waiting for it?
He's become extremely violent. Yeah.
He's not playing around anymore. I'll show you. That's something else I say on like a daily basis. I'll show you. I'll show you. Some dumb guy. Bust down the door of this guy's house.
It's like violence is great. It solves everything. That's bullshit.
Oh man, he knows what he's doing. He just crumbles it. Oh, come on. All right.
Don't be a bitch. Yeah. Get some hookers.
Let's go for hookers.
Yeah, it is.
I'm going to look up, see if I can find that tank top.
Yeah. What kind of abstract art is that?
It's like the reverse towers of Hanoi. You know?
Sure. You know
what I'm talking about?
No.
That little puzzle game where you like...
Nope.
What?
No.
The discs and you move them from one thing to the other?
No.
Yeah.
And have your fancy pants education.
What he forgot is that it's actually an Iron Maiden on the inside.
Or he faces all his weapons inward.
Well, that looks pretty flimsy. Just saying.
Yeah. He,
and the wood is already split.
Fleur was a, you know, good teacher. That guy could break out, no problem.
Is it a stretch to say that the Arcadian is aroused right now? Yes. Guess not. I love us. He has like master, like yeah, Seventh Heaven production skills.
Right, I was gonna say, how do you figure out how to use the system in like 5 minutes?
Know who that is?
No.
That's Ernie Reyes Jr. Do you know who that is? He's like the, he was in Surf Ninjas, for example.
Okay.
And lots of other things, the main character in Surf Ninjas. He is awesome. And his father, Ernie Reyes Sr., is like, was like an excellent choreographer, martial artist guy. He's also in Surf Ninjas, is the guy with the eye patch.
So all references will now point back to Surf Ninjas?
Yeah. Okay. Leslie Nielsen was the bad guy, which I find hilarious. And the kid used a, like a Game Gear. His brother used a Game Gear as like psychic. He'd play it and would show him what was going to happen.
Was it a Game Gear?
Pretty sure.
Or a Lynx.
I don't know. We would like the, he goes all zooming. Yes. He's like the, he's on the switchboard. It's like, where's the camera? Look at that. It's like into the soul of man.
Yeah. He's even got like the half face. Yeah. Lighting down.
It's like a doll's eyes. Like, does he have someone doing the lighting for these guys, too? Look at that. That's choreographed lighting.
Yeah, he knows his shit, I guess.
It sort of reminds me of that scene at the end of Mortal Kombat, where it's like, face your enemy, and it's like, yeah. All the souls that Shang Tsung has.
It's like just a guy in a suit.
Those guys weren't even aiming for him. Now get naked. Nice. It's like John Goodman, right? It's like in The Big Lebowski, John Goodman.
Except not crazy enough.
Shut the F up, Donnie. You're out of your element.
I like how he does the same move twice.
To show you the art of non-violence.
With violence.
Yeah. Look at him. He's like, yeah, get him, yeah. Johnny. Yes, love him.
It's like this shit actually works.
Boom. He He does an awesome kick at some point. I'll point it out when he does it. It's impressive. Oh. Yeah.
That's just like thug fighting.
Let's see. I think it might be coming up. I think it's when he jumps down off this podium. There you go. Nice.
Yeah.
That. It was like boom, boom, like cross directions.
So is there a point to that?
I don't know. Build up more
just
momentum.
Badass?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's hard to do. Oh, wait.
He's going to drive his way out of those ropes.
Yeah. Oh, he bushwhacked him. Zangief. It's like older Zangief who doesn't know what he's doing with his life. It's like Zangief Mr. T, right?
He's got identity problems. This is great. I don't think those are the sounds that are supposed to be.
Yeah, I know. Right? Yeah, man. Just got like so suddenly quiet.
Yeah.
So now you know, like from here on out, serious biz.
So, if he just challenged Sho'nuff from the beginning, none of this would have happened.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, Eddie Arcadian might still be after Lord Charles, though. So.
Yeah. But their paths might not have crossed.
What's his name again? I keep forgetting.
Who knows?
I'm Little Bro.
Little Bro?
Little Bro's about to get rocked. I think. Get the
classic, yeah.
Well, it seems like that's like a highly dangerous place to fire a gun, right? It's like all these like concrete corridors.
Yeah,
probably like, gonna shoot yourself somehow. Boom. There it is. I can't lose the Stitch. I'm cycling off whatever his name is. Ooh, man. So I was going to make him kiss the cons there for a second. Oh, it's like a ball pit filled with styrofoam, except for that one spot.
And pillows, yeah. And marshmallows, and then there's one canister.
It's like filled with liquid nitrogen that then spills all over his face. It's like, all right. He's like, I got spinal cord injuries, man. You might want to not roughhouse me like this. I love this guy. Like, how many wardrobes did he have throughout the movie?
Not enough. So he's got the padding now.
Yeah. I think that's a second tiger theme thing, too. Didn't he have, like, the white tiger, like, outfit before?
I don't know. Well, I wasn't keeping tabs on that.
I wonder if I could find, like, is there, like, a website devoted to, like,
Sho'nuff
fashion items?
I'm sure there is.
You know, like, the music, it's like, it's on now. It cues you in that this is the battle. It's weird, like, Sho'nuff, his, like, fighting style is so off. Like, he's so tense, and, like,
yeah.
But, like, it's somehow, like, it's off. He's in his shoulders too much. But it works. Love it. Ooh, that's something I use sometimes too, very rarely. I'm not sure if anyone ever notices. It's a very particular motion, right? You got to use the palms, like the inside of the palms. There it is right there. Inside of the palms and the sideburns. Yeah. Oh. It's funny because he sort of reminds me of Kareem Abdul-Jabbar in that movie. Like the Tower of Whatever, the one that Bruce Lee, I think, died before he finished. And, like, that character was supposed to represent, like, the ultimate in, like, formless fighting.
Right.
Which is sort of like what showed up. He's kind of got really, like, no technique. He's like a wild man.
Like that little convulsion.
He's play acting. Or was he? I love it. It's like you got the Undertaker bell right there.
Dun. Oh, man.
Something about this reminded me of, like, a little bit somewhere in Double Dragon, the music right there.
The temple?
Yeah. Yes, you know what I'm talking about. Yeah.
Like Shadow Temple, whatever.
Oh.
Oh, fucking red lights.
Yes. Like, everything. The stance, the hands, the beady eye. I love it. Like the tiger claw style. Like, the thing is, like, do you think only Leroy can see the glow because it was, like, aura, like, martial arts training? Like, do you think Eddie Arcadian sees this?
Could be just a martial arts thing.
Yeah. It's like, look at that face.
It's like, what's going on? It's a pretty shitty chain.
Oh, man, he didn't roll properly there.
No.
Oh, that was a mistake. You just gave him, like, the clothing battle damage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
At least a 15% increase in power.
This guy doesn't watch Dragon Ball Z because he just messed up.
I don't think it existed yet, but you should have known about it.
I thought that was actually cool, right? Because it's the same scene, but from his point of view.
Yeah.
So I thought that was actually, like, cool. Oh. I've actually done that once in my life, and it was maybe the coolest moment of my life. Like, caught a fist in the hand and did the crunch.
The crunch.
See, I guess he's seeing that. Maybe because Leroy's like, you know, some next level shit that even peasants can see it. Is that possible?
Well, that was less... That wasn't the glow. That was just...
Oh! Oh! Show knew his game was up right there. I like how, like, the electricity in his hands was, like, fizzling.
Yeah.
Couldn't handle it. Oh, let's get the... Uh-oh. Slow-mo.
You got this Converse wet. It's just...
It's like he slipped out. It's like a Naruto, like, yeah. Ninjutsu, whatever. It's like just right. Too close. That's what I, when I first saw the movie, that's what I thought, because it looked like he wasn't really there. Crazy.
Murder, yeah. Of course the police come right now.
Well, there was the gunshot, so. Missed enough.
Yeah. High five.
That's some solid high five. It's white day.
Does that mean that Kung Fu has been purified?
I guess. Now, is this supposed to be, like, right after, right? Because, like, the people were like, you're on right now, you know?
Yeah.
So, where'd everyone go to get their, like, rapid wardrobe change and a dozen white roses? That would be a sick wedding outfit. Thank you. Yeah. See a chick who had like a unicorn horn coming out of her hair? See?
Oh, yeah.
Whatever. No, it just becomes like jazz nightclub music. I think this is all backwards.
Yeah. That was a waste of good bouquet right there.
Yeah. Oh, wait, no. He timed it perfectly. It's funny, like, her eyeliner thing is like the Bride of Frankenstein, but not in the hair, but extending to the hair.
Hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That, like, yeah. It's cool. I can dig it. Lord Charles. Lord Charles knows what's up later. I'm guessing that this music is not what they're actually hearing. Because the dancing doesn't make sense.
Yeah, that's... Maybe something that changed in post.
Eddie Arcadia like shoots out one of the cable wires and they just plummet to their death. And then his zooming faces on the thing.
Again.
Alright. I remember, do you remember if there's like anything that happens after the credits?
What, like Sho'nuff like emerging again?
I guess we'll have to stick it out though, stick it out the credits. So it's done. Trying to see, you know, you're always waiting for that one person that's gonna save you with the ridiculous name.
Yeah.
So far. I don't know. Best we got is Richard Pay Crudo. P, not Pay. Oh. Yeah, okay.
That laser transition.
Yeah. I can't remember, like, I mean, the Rhythm of the Night song, I know I've heard before. I'm not sure if any of these other songs ever really had a shelf life beyond
this movie.
I expect a little bit more, you know, fight choreography going on.
There was none. It was a, just do whatever you want.
Like, I want this to be like the end of Turtles in Time, where it's like, and then it's like, you know, pause, some credits, you know what I mean?
I haven't seen that movie since...
No, the game, Super Nintendo game, remember how, like...
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I was thinking both Time and Turtles 3, and I'm like, no, I don't want to remember that movie.
No. There you go. Someone totally busted us up on that, on our Turtles in Time, video a game review or let's play, because we said that in the intro, we're like, oh, you mix Turtles and time travel, like, you know, it's got to be good, right? And then someone was like, dude, the third movie.
Oh,
that's true. You're right.
That is very true.
I want to see if like test drive and stuff like show up. No, they don't.
No.
I love how the leads, they just don't have last names.
Nope.
This song is pretty cool. The Glow song. That bass sound, that like,
yeah.
Hear it? It reminds me of the beginning of Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure, when like the, remember like this, the gem thing is like coming down that eventually turns into the phone booth? What is that song? It's like, doo boo doo boo doo boo. It's like,
Yeah, I know what you're saying, but I can't.
Mm.
Special. Oh, Technicolor. And Metrocolor.
Metrocolor.
Yeah, they had all different, like, colors. I don't know enough about that sort of stuff, but every, like, studio or whatever had, like, its own, like, color treatment. It was, like, you know, Technicolor, Metrocolor, Panicolor. But, yeah, well, you were asking earlier at some point, I think, maybe before we turn the cameras on, what the TriStar has to do with Pegasus.
Mm-hmm.
But it said TriStar Delphi, right?
Mm.
Like the Oracle of Delphi.
Okay.
Maybe there's some, I don't know. But I guess, is there some, like, you know, bonus scene Avengers style? Guess not. Nope.
All right, let's hit the lights.
Okay. Now the camera screams in adjustment.
All right. So, I don't know what I really want to say here, but here it is, The Last Dragon, one of my favorite movies of all time. So, I don't know, is there anything to say to wrap things up, besides Sho'nuff?
Sho'nuff.
No?
I think it's still a good movie, still holds up.
Yeah, there's a lot going on in that movie, like... There's, like, a lot of plot threads. It could have been much simpler.
Yeah, I mean, it gets a... You know, obviously, it's over the top in most of it, but...
Yeah. I will say Taimak, he, like, you know, the movie, like, rises or falls on the strength of him pulling off that sort of, like, innocent ass kicker. But I think he does.
Yeah, definitely the I don't want to do this, but I must type of situation. And
yeah.
And he learned some moves.
All right, well... I hope you found this cool. I hope we don't get, you know, copyright sued or anything like that, but we'll see. Let us know in the comments, and if this is something you enjoy, maybe we'll watch other awesome 80s movies. I know I got a lot in my mind that I'd like to see.
Yeah, I guess 80s, 70s, all that stuff. Back when, like, practical effects were
the
thing.
I don't know. Maybe we'll branch out, but I think, I don't know, I think 80s are our wheelhouse. What'd you think?
Yeah, I can agree with that.
You're going to allow it?
Yeah, I'll allow it.
All right, so I guess we'll see you next time on Retromancers. Done.
Good.
All right. I'm freaking sweating like a beast.